Welcome to AETCM. Today we will show how to conduct a cardiac arrest management module. We have a patient scenario here. We have a 35-year-old patient, known case of severe interstitial lung disease, presently admitted in the hospital. He was having breathing difficulty today morning. He was found unresponsive in the wards, hospital wards. Let's see how the patient assessment and cardiac arrest management is being done. So a 45-year-old patient is lying in the hospital bed, unresponsive. There is a person, staff currently coming to the patient for assessment. He is assessing the patient, checking for response first. After getting no response from the patient, he has called for help. After calling for help, he is checking the carotid pulse, center pulse, and scanning for respiratory effort. Maximum of 10 seconds he will give for assessing the pulse. If in 10 seconds he is not getting the pulse, he is starting CPR. So here in this scenario, there is only a single rescuer here. He has called for help. So since it's a in-hospital scenario, we have got our advanced cardiac team available. So since call for help, code blue was placed, our advanced cardiac team has arrived on scene. Let's see how the advanced cardiac team will assess the patient and manage the cardiac arrest.
Dr. Karthiani, you take care of the chest compressions. Dr. Riaz, you take care of the airway. Give two rescue breaths after 30 compressions. And meanwhile, arrange for waveform capnography. Dr. Vivek, please secure an IV cannula and load 1 mg of epinephrine with 10 ml NS.
Two large bore cannulas are secure.
Take starting at 30 compressions.
Dr. Binu, take care of the cardiac monitors, connect the cardiac monitors. And Dr. Sabha, you document all the events.
Document 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
So every two rescue breath is given after 30 compressions. Rescue breath is given over 1 second, and a good chest wall arise will show that rescue breath is successful. Chest compressions are done with minimal interruptions. We have to maintain a minimum rate of 100 to 120 compressions per minute. Chest wall recoil should be maintained. Chest wall depth of minimum 5 cm, that is 2.5 inches, has to be made, and minimize chest compression interruptions.
Since the cardiac monitor is connected, we will assess the rhythm. Dr. Yes. Okay. So it is showing an asystole. So please check for the lead connections. Leads are connected properly
leads
or not?
Are connected properly.
Connected properly. Chest, check whether there is any power disconnections. Okay. Check all the leads.
Okay.
Please check the sensitivity also.
Sensitivity also changed.
So it is an asystole. So Dr. Vivek, please load 1 mg of epinephrine followed by with 10 ml NS followed by a 10 ml of NS flush.
1 mg adrenaline given followed by 10 ml saline flush.
Okay, continue CPR and rescue breaths. Meanwhile, arrange for an advanced airway and a waveform capnography. Dr. Vivek, please take an arterial blood gas sample.
Arterial blood gas is taken.
Okay. Dr. Vivek, please, Dr. Riaz, please secure the advanced airway. Okay. Now we will give breaths in 5 to 6 seconds. Okay. So meanwhile, we'll assess the 5 Hs and 5 Ts. So 5 Hs, the most common cause is hypoxia. Maybe hypoxia may be the cause of cardiac arrest in this case. Other conditions are hyperkalemia, let the ABG results come, or acidosis, or it can be because of any hypovolemia, hypertension, or hypothermia. Then 5 Ts we'll assess. There can be a pneumothorax, cardiac thrombus, pulmonary thrombus, toxins, or attention pneumothorax, or cardiac tamponade.
In all cardiac arrest cases, we have to think about the reversible causes of cardiac arrest and rule them out. Once reversible causes of cardiac arrest ruled out, then we can continue the ACLS protocol as it is. The ideal time for a intubation of the patient or securing a definitive airway will be at the time of reassessment, because at time of reassessment for 10 seconds anyhow we will be stopping the CPR. Otherwise if you are reassessing, otherwise if you are intubating the patient with a definitive airway, it will be trying not to interrupt the chest compressions as such. So whenever the reassessment is there, the documentation person can alert the team leader.
Time for reassessment, 2 minutes are done.
Okay. Please stop CPR. Let me reassess. So patient is still in asystole. So we load the next dose of epinephrine. 1 mg, 1 in 1000 dilution, followed by 10 ml NS flush.
Epinephrine given, followed by saline flush.
Continue CPR and continue breaths in 5 to 6 seconds.
So we will continue the CPR as per the ACLS asystole protocol. After the definitive airway securing, the compressions will continue at a rate of 100 to 120 beats per compressions per minute, and definitive airway through which we will give one rescue breath every 6 seconds. So that will be fixedly continuing, and in every 2 minutes we will be reassessing the patient to assess the current status of the patient. If no improvement, we will continue giving injection adrenaline 1 ampule, that is 1 mg in 1 in 10,000 dilution with the NS flush, and we will continue reassessment of the patient.
2 minutes are done, time for reassessment.
Please reassess the rhythm. Okay. Second strolling, asystole.
Since the rhythm is still asystole, we will continue the CPR.
Continue epinephrine.
Epinephrine is again given.
Epinephrine given, followed by saline flush.
ABG potassium is 7.2.
Okay, so it is there is hyperkalemia in the ABG. So we will be giving soda bicarbonate. Dr. Vivek, please load 50 milliequivalents of soda bicarbonate and administer to the patient.
50 milliequivalents of soda bicarbonate given.
Other than soda bicarbonate, any other drug that would like to be?
You can load GI bolus. GI bolus. 25% dextrose with 8 units human atrapid administered to the patient as a bolus dose, and you can also load 10 ml 10% of calcium gluconate bolus.
10 ml of 10% calcium gluconate is given. GI bolus start dose is given.
You can continue epinephrine in every 3 minutes.
Done, time for reassessment.
Reassessment shows asystole again. The lead placements are still in right, and the lead selection, please check the leads again. Yes. Power connection is okay, leads are okay, sensitivity is still okay. So patient is remaining in asystole.
So CPR has been continuing for last 30 minutes. Patient is still persisting to be in asystole. No improvement in rhythm has been achieved till now.
Two minutes are done, time for reassessment.
We'll reassess the rhythm. Please stop CPR. So it is showing an organized rhythm with a rate of 65. Please check for the central pulse.
Central pulse is present.
Central pulse is present. So we have attained ROSC. So we will go for post cardiac arrest management.
So the patient is resuscitated and ROC is achieved, and the cardiac arrest team is starting post cardiac arrest care. So the cardiac arrest management was successful.